Greetings. I was watching the news recently and was amazed. Okay, I'm always amazed at what passes as news. The story I found so amazing was a story about the current inflation, but curiously never ever used the word inflation. Instead, it was a story about shrinkage. Let's quickly review some basics. The common meaning of inflation is that the item costs more. To buy the same thing today costs more than buying the same thing in the past. Consider going to the store to buy an item. You previously could buy the item for $5, but now it will cost you $6. The price has increased. That is inflation. Now suppose the price stays the same, but you get less of an item. That is still inflation, but in a hidden form. To get the same quantity as the original purchase costs more. But to see the inflation, you must compare the price of some base unit of the item. You can call this calculated value or base value the unit price. You calculate the unit price using division. For example, if you can buy a six-pack of cola for $3, the unit cost for a cola is $3 divided by 6 cans, or 50 cents a can. You divide the total cost by the quantity of units. If you buy something which has quantity 1, like a ladder, a TV, or a computer, the price you paid is the same as the unit price because you bought 1. But if you buy something that has a volume or quantity more than 1, the unit price will be the total cost divided by the quantity. Inflation can be seen when the unit cost is increasing. And that is an aspect of the deception or incompetence of the news story.
Psst! The price is staying the same. There is no inflation. There is no inflation. There is no inflation. There is no inflation.
Now, pay attention to the following news story from ABC. This will describe packages 10% smaller, but at the same price. That is actually more than 10% inflation. Going on right now in America. But they manage to do the whole story, and never once say the word inflation.
Next tonight, World News investigates something still happening in grocery stores across America. Your favorite foods shrinking right inside the packages, but the price stays the same.
Your favorite foods shrinking right inside the packages, but the price stays the same.
ABC's chief business correspondent Rebecca Jarvis gives you some real answers on how to spot it.
Ready for some grocery shopping?
Just as the appetites of Kristen Quinn's children are starting to grow.
Apple,
so let's
apple.
Get
one apple?
Yes, perfect.
Good. She's finding less product for the old price.
Less product for the old price. That would be inflation.
This is just not something that would ever come on my radar.
Edgar Dworsky at Consumer World.
Well, hello there.
Has spent his career tracking products and shrinking packaging.
Take a look.
So this is the new, and this is the old.
Take a look at these two boxes of crackers. What you may not have noticed, the new package has 20 fewer crackers.
And you have to go back to the store.
And how about these juice boxes? Guess what? Identical prices. But the new one, 10% less juice.
Identical prices, 10% less juice. That would be inflation.
So in essence, we've lost one of those 10 boxes in the new package. So,
and it's not just
Pampers.
Food.
Yeah, you go through a lot of these.
Yes. All day long. This large pack of Pampers used to hold 100 diapers. Now it's shrunk to 92, even though it's still $26 a pack. So Kristen will be spending $200 more on diapers before her baby's potty trained.
Gee, it will cost $200 more. That would be inflation.
And look what's blushing away right before our eyes.
Ladies, you can't squeeze the Charmin.
Dworsky says there's 70% less to squeeze now than 20 years ago. And remember Kristen's favorite brand?
The old width was 4 1/4 inches. The new width is less than 4.
Another thing you may not notice at the grocery store. They're older, bigger bags right next to the new, smaller versions.
What's the difference between these two?
The new one, almost 2 ounces less.
So do some checking before you hit the checkout.
Now, we reached out to the manufacturers who told us when their costs rise, they sometimes adjust the amount of products in the packages. And remember those cookies? Well, here they are. Hard to tell on the surface which one is the bigger package, which one is the smaller one. Of course, this is the smaller package. It's the newer one. 6 fewer cookies. The net weight is where you find that answer.
So you have to become an expert on the weight. On
net
the
weight.
Okay, Rebecca, thank you so much. Eye-opening as always.
So the media is helping to program you to not see inflation. The economy is far more fragile now than they dare admit. Since 1980, I've heard preachers and teachers say to get out of debt. If you heard, listened, and took heed, you will fare much better in the days ahead. If you face a decision to get into more debt right now, I advise against it, unless it's critical. Decide to live within your means and your income. Learn to live within your means and your income. That may mean canceling your cable or dish network. It may mean not replacing furniture that still works. You must use judgment for your situation. The Bible foretells of a one-world economic system, Revelation 13:16, and He causes all, the small and the great, and the rich and the poor, and the free men and the slaves, to be given a mark on their right hand or on their forehead. And He provides that no one will be able to buy or to sell except the one who has the mark, either the name of the beast or the number of his name. I believe it will be brought about by the collapse of the old economic system. That means the current system we now have. Have you so quickly forgotten the near collapse of Europe recently? The landmines are already in place to collapse America's currency and banking system. And we have already seen other countries confiscate bank accounts with no public recourse. Be prepared, brothers and sisters, for the coming economic shocks. Have some cash on hand, but realize American currency may quickly have little or no value. This will be a time for placing our faith in Almighty God, even for miracles. If your faith is in God, you will be able to remain in peace. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.